Paramahamsa Nityananda is a rare living incarnation, a yogi by birth. He has been expressing his power of enlightenment since birth. He has authored more than 500 books in Tamil and English, books in Telugu, Kannada, Malayalam, Hindi, Sanskrit, Gujarati, Oriya, Bengali, Marathi, French, Malay, Polish, Portuguese, Italian, German, Danish, Spanish, Russian and Chinese, with translations in 26 languages are available. He is also an exemplary speaker with over 8,000 hours of profound life solutions through his discourses. Social services such as Annadan, free medical care, free educational services, ashrams, schools, temples, hospitals established in more than 140 places around the world offer exceptional services. A powerful spiritual healer who has healed millions of people of diseases from migraine to cancer. A Kriya Yogi who has formulated Kriyas for physical health and mental well-being, benefiting thousands. A living master who offers practical solutions for our everyday problems. Having meditation centers in 151 countries including Bidadi, Thiruvannamalai, Rajapalayam, Salem, Hyderabad, Varanasi, Los Angeles, Ohio, Seattle, San Jose and Phoenix. He is the founder and spiritual head of Nityananda Dhyanapeetam, a spiritual guru for 10 million followers, an incarnation who transmits the highest spiritual energy through initiation. A contemporary yogi who has revived the Vedic science of yoga worldwide through thousands of yoga centers. Adept in Ashtamahasiddhis, mystical yogic powers, he has effortlessly awakened the kundalini of thousands, gracing them with spiritual powers. A spiritual powerhouse who has revived the sacred Vedic tradition by establishing Vedic temples worldwide in places like Los Angeles, San Jose, Seattle, Toronto, Ohio, Oklahoma, Phoenix, St. Louis, Malaysia, Brazil, Paris, Guadeloupe, Dallas, New York, New Jersey, Atlanta, Calgary, Vancouver, Singapore, and places like Bangalore, Hyderabad and Thiruvannamalai in India. A dynamic young guru who is an inspiration to thousands of youngsters. India's most watched spiritual guru online. A beacon of spiritual light who has triumphed over the forces of religious terrorism and political persecution. Paramahamsa Nityananda is an eternal Kalpataru, blessing the world with the boons of material abundance and spiritual enlightenment.
Nityanandaya swagatam, nityamuktam nirvikalpam, dhyana loka pradipakam, vande shantamayam bandham, nityanandaya swagatam, ananda gandha sancharam, sarvopadhi vinirmuktam, vande jnanalayam natham, nityanandaya swagatam.
Just as embodied one goes through tenderness of boyhood, bloom of youthfulness and infirmity of old age in this body, in the same manner it takes on another body, the awakened one who knows this does not get perplexed by these changes. Teachings of Krishna should not be commented. It should just be repeated. Please understand, all the words I am talking, all the words I am uttering are just to create the kind of intimacy which was there between Arjuna and Krishna. It is the context which makes meaning of all these words. A small story. One drunken man gets on the bus late night, staggers up to the seat and sits next to an elderly priest. He looks the man up and down and says, "I've got the news for you. You are going straight to hell." Immediately the man jumps out of his seat and shouts, "To God, I am in the wrong bus." He thinks bus is going to the hell. No. All words make meaning only in context. You need to know the reason. These great words cannot be commented. Then you may ask, then what am I doing? I am continuously trying to create context. Means making the feeling connection which was there between Krishna and Arjuna to happen here between us. Whenever the context happens, immediately words make meaning. It hits you. But the feeling connection Arjuna had has to happen. The extraordinary feeling connection Arjuna was cherishing, somehow that can be created. I think the context is created. With the context, all these words make meaning. Sharada Devi goes to Rameshwaram. All the priests have realized her greatness, that she is the Guru Mata of Vivekananda. Vivekananda became popular by that time. Ramanathapuram king supported Vivekananda's trip to US and paid money for the trip. After he became successful, so many people claimed their association with Vivekananda, but nobody supported Vivekananda. Before he went to US, he became popular. And not only that, even after the success, many of them did not stand by Vivekananda during his lifetime. After he passed away, he left the body, everybody started associating themselves. Because there were a lot of rumors around Vivekananda also. As many of the young lady disciples living around the young Swami, and there was a lot of rumors and scandals around him. So many were not supporting when he was in the body, especially before the success, before the US trip. But Ramanathapuram Raja is the one who realized his greatness before and stood by him even after. And when the Vivekananda visited, he stayed in the palace. And when Vivekananda came back to India, Raja put his head on the ground and told, "You put your feet first on my head, then put it on this ground." So Ramanathapuram Raja Sedupathi, he received Vivekananda. See, when Vivekananda came from the boat, he came by ship. From ship, he landed in a boat. From boat, he came to the land, Rameshwaram. So Raja first put his head on the ground and said, "You put your feet on my head first, because I like to show all over India, this is the place." He put his head, his leg first when he landed on India. And literally, Vivekananda was forced to put his feet because Raja was not allowing him. See, understand, those days Raja means really he was a king. It's not like this modern day. After the independence, the kings are just having only the name, not the kingdom. But he was really king.
Discover the power of Kundalini Awakening at Kalpataru, a unique full-day transformational program. Blessed personally by rare living incarnation Paramahamsa Nityananda. What is Kundalini? Kundalini is the tremendous potential energy hidden inside every individual, which can be awakened through initiation by an enlightened master. Once awakened, Kundalini has the power to transform every area of your life and bring you health, wealth, success, joyful relationships, and spiritual enlightenment.
Harness the power of meditation and initiation. Experience a glimpse of Kundalini awakening at Kalpataru. Manifest your destiny. Every weekend at Nityananda Dhyanapetam, Nityananda Nagar, Bidadi, Bengaluru.
विश्वेश्वराय महादेवाय त्र्यंबकाय त्रिपुरा गायत्रिकाग्निकालाय कालाग्निरुद्राय नीलकाय मृत्युञ्जयाय सर्वेश्वराय सदा शिवाय शंकराय श्रीमन्महादेवाय नमः नमो हिरण्यवाघवे सेनान्ये दिशां च पतये नमो नमो वृक्षेभ्यो हरिकेशेभ्यः पशूनां पतये नमो नमः सस्मिञ्जराय त्रिशीमदे पतीनां पतये नमो नमो बभ्लुषाय विव्याधिने नानां पतये
And just the Ramanadapuram Ramanatha Swami temple alone, I don't know how many tons of gold they are having. This is a gift by Sethupathi Raja. See, the temple golden chariot alone is 3-ton gold. It is made out of pure gold, not copper sheet and gold layer. And I am talking about one property. Like this, I don't know what all. This whole thing is a gift by Raja. King to the Rameshwaram temple, and still that punya, even the present king and queen and prince, all of them are same way deeply devoted, and still that the blood or the punya of serving Vivekananda is there. So when Sharada Devi went, the priests have realized that her greatness, she is the Guru Mata of Vivekananda. She was directly taken inside the Garbha Mandir. Please understand, even Vivekananda did not have that respect or privilege. He was not able to enter into the Garbha Mandir. As per the rule of the Hindu sannyas tradition, if you cross the ocean, you can't be a sannyasi. Even though the Raja was respecting Vivekananda so much, the priests have said, no, we will not allow him inside the Garbha Mandir. It is so unfortunate. Sometimes the fanatics and the fanaticism. Anyhow, I don't want to talk much about that, but they did not allow Vivekananda inside the Garbha Mandir, but they allowed the Sharada Devi inside the Garbha Mandir. She went into Samadhi and she was doing Puja Abhishekam directly to Ramanatha Swami with the water she brought from Ganges. She brought specially the Ganga water. She was pouring, doing Abhishekam. She was in Samadhi. One of the close disciple, assistant, was taking care of Sharada Devi, a lady disciple. She just saw mother in Samadhi and doing Abhishekam. Then she just took little water, sprinkling that Abhishekam water, and sprinkled on herself and looked at the mother and asked mother, because the disciple saw mother is in Samadhi. She asked Sharada Devi, please bless me, tell me some word, tell me something to bless me or give me some teaching, some mantra, something. She is in Samadhi and the person is asking is a close disciple. She doesn't need to sell herself. Sharada Devi does not need to sell herself to that close disciple who is serving her for years. The disciple is convinced Sharada Devi is an incarnation. That's why she is serving. Sharada Devi just turned and said, he is there as I installed. The linga was installed by Sita Devi. She just made one statement. She is there as I installed. That's all. She meant everything. One, the Shiva's presence is there. Second, she is the incarnation. She installed it. And third, she meant to the disciple, you are serving me, what more you need, relax. All the three, she finished in one statement. She says about the glory of the God, divine, and glory of herself, self-introduction, and spiritual path for the disciple who asked. All three she finished in one statement. He is here, as I installed. I am the one who installed. You are serving me, what more you need, relax. Anyhow, the disciple just got into ecstasy, held mother's hand, helped mother to complete the abhishekam and come out, and she sprinkled the water from the mother's feet when mother came out. Charanamrita, we call it. The punchline is, when the disciple came out, another one person asked this disciple what mother said in the Garbha Mandir. I heard something she was telling. So in the enthusiasm, this disciple said, mother said, he is there as I installed. So that guy, naturally logical and with violence. See, with violence you can never understand spirituality. I am not teaching non-violence as a morality. I am teaching non-violence as a basic qualification for you to have sensitivity to receive the great spiritual truths.
क्या आप स्वयं एक अवतार पुरुष से अपने जीवन में दिव्य मार्गदर्शन चाहते हैं? प्रस्तुत करते हैं अवतार पुरुष से वार्ता।
नित्यानंदम, नित्यानंदा हियर।
परमहंस नित्यानंदा संसार को एक और अतुल्य और अनोखी भेंट दे रहे हैं।
Got practically everything and too much for a phone call.
अब वो लाइव किसी के भी प्रश्नों का उत्तर स्वयं देंगे.
That's great. Now you ask anything you want in your life. Ask me any boon you want.
आठ से प्रारंभ. कुछ सौभाग्यशाली लोग जो 0800-272-7999 पर फोन करेंगे, वो स्वयं स्वामी जी से बात कर सकते हैं. लाइव देखें एनटीवी पर ntv.nityananda.org.
The Ingenious Program, a field of all possibilities. The children in the Ingenious Program are directly under the guidance of enlightened master Paramahamsa Nityananda. Nityananda is an incarnation and exudes the knowledge of conflict-free living. He states that enlightenment is our birthright. What an incredible gift for your child, a once-in-a-lifetime privilege to live and thrive in the energy field of all possibilities and give enlightenment to your child. Where every child can become a genius. Learning can unveil the genius in every child, provided it stimulates higher order thinking skills, positive self-esteem, teamwork, and an internal locus of control. Research has proven that holistic teaching methodologies paired with meditation stimulate whole brain functioning and result in self-directed, spontaneous, and creative lifelong learners. An enriched environment. When young children have an enriched environment conducive to early learning in life, they have higher IQ, cognitive intelligence, EQ, social emotional intelligence, and SQ, spiritual intelligence. These early experiences are critical for the development of the child. Peer pressure and destructive social conditioning can take its toll on the child. It can create negative thought patterns and destructive behaviors unless these enriching experiences are provided. An enriched environment includes whole brain activities which stimulate the utilization of both sides of the brain. The right brain is responsible for creativity, intuition, spontaneity, quantum memory, learning in a flash, and computer-like calculations. The left side of the brain is responsible for inner linear thinking and analysis. When both sides of the brain are integrated, performance is optimal. Brain yoga. Brain yoga activates the ability to balance the right and the left brain. This helps open the sixth sense. Children are given activities to balance both sides of the body simultaneously using distinctive postures that stimulate both sides. The neurological brain patterns move from beta to alpha, increasing alertness and attention. Quantum memory. Quantum memory is a constant downloading of information without interference of the mind. Observation skills are directly related to memory skills. Reading without interference of the mind, reading at quantum speed, will lead to quantum memory without the mind getting in the way. Creative and performing arts. Dance, drama, music, sculpting, and design offered in the Ingenious program provide kinesthetic motor stimulation to engage the brainwave patterns, resulting in expanded creativity and resourcefulness. Sattvic food. Children are given the benefit of fresh sattvic food prepared to the standards according to the ancient Vedic lifestyle. The food is fresh, with fruits and vegetables. Vegetarian food creates radiant health in the body. Vedic cultural arts. Sanskrit chanting stimulates the brain to produce full brain coherence, developing clearer perception and integrated thinking. Chanting also promotes inner silence and improves the attention span. Meditation and expanded awareness. Meditation instills a deep silence in the child, resulting in deeper, richer perception and clarity in thinking. Ingenious produces the next step in evolution, a mature human being who functions at a higher state of consciousness. Expanded awareness provides the platform for a vision of all abilities of life, perfect health, prosperity, and life without conflict. What more could you ask for your child?
If I can just teach this one science to the kids, I will have millions of enlightened beings.
That is why in violent, warring countries, spiritual truths never grows. Our civilization is such, created for spiritual enlightenment, spiritual growth. In a warring situation, warring country, you can never have spiritual growth. I think that is the reason, before the war itself, Krishna gives everything to Arjuna. Agitated place, agitated mind, cannot grasp the great truths. The person with suffering with the logic, perverted logic syndrome. Medicine makes meaning only to the person to whom it is given. These words are also medicine. The problem is you are also having the same problem, but you are not understanding the doctor is capable of giving you medicine. Medicine makes meaning for you, trying to create that same feeling connection which Arjuna and Krishna had, so that all these words can become alive, it can be just lit up in your inner space. The feeling connection can be created in at least three ways: ordinary love, ordinary human love, which leads to physical relationship, like an ordinary householder. Unfortunately, the moment the physical intimacy reaches its peak, the valley starts happening, the ordinary love starts disappearing. See, now the ordinary love feels too much needs to be compromised for this peak. For this love to be kept alive, too many things need to be sacrificed. The love will not be able to survive the sacrifices the life need to make to keep that love alive. An ordinary love, empty, meaningless, most used, abused word. The second way of creating that same feeling connection is by impressing people with certain ideas. The third way, the feeling connection which can be created, and which only grows, 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 never comes down, is the feeling connection by constantly giving the spiritual truths to people. That is what I am working now. Understand the feeling connection created by ordinary love disappears in few years. Oh, maybe I can say few months. Feeling connection created by a kind of an ideology disappears maybe in few years. Feeling connection created by the spiritual truths. Constantly the spiritual truths are added into you, just as the embodied one goes through tenderness of boyhood, bloom of youthfulness, and infirmity of old age in this body, in the same manner it takes on another body. The awakened one who knows this does not get perplexed by these changes. You don't worry when your boyhood turns into youthfulness, because you just know you are going to continue to exist. Then why do you worry when the old age turns into death and assuming another own body? Because you are afraid you may not continue. I tell you, anybody with a simple logic can see how can life end with one body. Just to do this drama of 100 years, I don't think you need so many tools and weapons and instruments like a mind, intelligence, consciousness. No.
Just an hour's drive from Bangalore, Asia's fastest growing city, is a unique space of healing, meditation and rejuvenation. Welcome to Nityananda Dhyanapeetam. Experience soothing, healing energies under the ancient wish-fulfilling banyan tree in the presence of divinity. Enjoy the unique anti-aging formula of the original Siddha Healing Spa with the 21-foot energized healing lingam and healing pool, the Vaidya Sarovar. Connect directly to God in the vibrant silence of Nityanandeshwara Temple. Savor the delicious sattvic food served free at all times. Best of all, get a glimpse of authentic spiritual life at the daily morning satsang, worship, yoga and meditation sessions with Paramahamsa Nityananda. Rediscover yourself at Nityananda Dhyanapeetam, the ultimate spiritual lifestyle destination. Nityananda Dhyanapeetam, Nityananda Nagar, Biridi, Bengaluru, 97422-03311.
The fear of discontinuity is only for those short-sighted fools. Please understand, Krishna is not promoting any religious concept or philosophy. He is not teaching any theology. He is talking to his close friend who is in a big crisis. He is counseling his personal friend who is in a big crisis. He is naturally not only honest, too straight. Come on, Arjuna. Just as the consciousness goes through the tenderness of the boyhood and bloom of the youthfulness and infirmity of old age in this body, In the same manner, it takes another body. The awakened one who knows this does not get perplexed. I am not able to add one word in this verse and delete one word. There are many other translations which says very blindly, oh, just like a spirit passes through a childhood, youth and old age. No, the spirit does not pass through childhood, old age and youth. It goes through the tenderness of boyhood, bloom of youthfulness and infirmity of old age. Please understand, it goes through only the characters of boyhood, youthfulness and old age. The awakened one who knows this does not get perplexed by these changes. Krishna is so straight. Drop all the fears you carry about the discontinuity. Whether the wealth, money you accumulated in the outer world, or the wealth, all the great qualities you accumulated in the inner world, does not get disconnected due to your death and next birth. The sacred secrets move from one body to another body, just like how you move from boyhood to youth, from youth to old age. Same way you just move from old age to death and death to again birth, next womb, next birth, and from birth again childhood, then youth. You don't lose anything. Understand? This is the first thing. Second thing, maybe you will believe this much. I think I don't lose my inner good qualities. The karma comes, the mental pattern comes with me, I know. But what will happen to all the wealth I created? Don't worry. You take birth again in the same family, same type of family. I don't want to say same family. Same kind of family where the same amount of wealth is there. So don't think you will die as a billionaire and take birth roadside, live in slum. No. Neither the great qualities you accumulated in the inner world nor the wealth you accumulated in the outer world is lost by death. Understand? Same way, if you accumulated tremendous laziness in the inner world and poverty, which is side effect of the laziness in the outer world, even death cannot take that away from you. After death also, that will continue to be with you. So if you want to transform your life, do it when you are alive. That is why I am saying, suicide is not the way to escape from any problem. I can give you some example. Now in this sutra, the science of life and death, now this science is evolving in a big way called NDE, near-death experience. If you just Google and see all the near-death experience websites and experiences, then you will understand what the modern science is discovering by the different testimonials and experiences and researches thousands of years before. My ancestors, my predecessors have clearly studied and defined without any doubt the science of life and death.